to Robert Mueller in his Russia investigation, may eventually testify against other members of the president's transition team, his White House, or even possibly against the president himself. But we only know what's in the court filings so far. The president's lawyers are already firing back. Meantime, Republican senators say passage of the tax reform bill is not a question of if, but when. The GOP senators say they have the votes they need to get to the finish line. The roll call could happen on the Senate floor within hours. We'll head there live if the Senate Majority Leader speaks. Wall Street took a nosedive today after the Flynn reports this morning, but as you see, bounced back after Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell announced he has the votes to pass tax reform in the Senate, heading then to a conference committee with the House before a vote on a final package. In the end, the Dow lost 40 after being down more than 250 at one point today. The S&P 500 fell 5, the NASDAQ dropped 26. The illegal immigrant acquitted of murder and the shooting death of a San Francisco woman last night is now the subject of a federal arrest warrant. Jose Garcia Zarate was found not guilty yesterday in the killing of Kate Steinle. And Secretary of State Rex Tillerson is laughing off reports that he's about to lose his job, and his boss is now backing him up on Twitter. A lot of news today, but we begin with the Russia investigation. Chief Intelligence Correspondent Catherine Herridge is at the D.C. District Court tonight with the latest. Good evening, Catherine.
But General Flynn is now required to fully cooperate, and that raises the stakes for President Trump, his son-in-law Jared Kushner, and other members of his inner circle.
After 33 years of military service, including 5 years in combat, retired general and former National Security Advisor Mike Flynn stood composed before a federal judge and pled guilty to a felony lying to the FBI. Democrats praised the plea as a milestone.
There is broader exposure of other people within the transition team and possibly within the administration. And so I don't think we've seen the end of this.
With his wife in the front row, Flynn told the judge he willingly and knowingly waived his right to a trial by his peers. And as part of the deal, Flynn will fully cooperate with Special Counsel Robert Mueller's Russia investigation. 4 days after the inauguration, newly unsealed court records show Flynn sat down with FBI agents and during the interview misled them about his contact with Russian Ambassador Sergei Kislyak. Legal experts said the plea deal may be a stepping stone to targets inside the White House.
It turns up the pressure on other individuals. It causes people in the White House to wonder what's coming next, who's going to go next. And I think all of that is designed to get cooperation from these people and for Mueller to send a signal to the White House that he's here playing hardball.
Republicans disagreed.
I've seen no evidence at all indicating that there's any connection between General Flynn and the president, anything involving Russian collusion.
In a statement, Flynn said, it has been extraordinarily painful to endure months of false allegations of treason and other outrageous acts. Flynn said what he did was wrong, and through his faith, he would set things right.
By pleading, he's admitted the falsity of it, the materiality of it, and the intent to deceive.